Hello, my name is Score Chaser, and this is going to be absolutely amazing. This right here is the Hasbro Spangler's Proton Pack. I got this as part of a crowdfunding campaign that was done by Haslabs last October that it started, I believe. It's been over a year since I've been waiting for this thing, and I probably will cry upon opening this because I have been a lifelong Ghostbusters fan, and having an actual Proton Pack, like something that's more resembling of something that you would see on the screen, has been a lifelong dream of mine ever since I was a kid. I started off with a Proton Pack that my mom made for me out of cereal boxes and paper towel tubes. I got the Kenner Proton Pack, and earlier, like a year or so prior, I got the Spirit Proton Pack, which is not full size, and the wand is a lot smaller than it should be. So let's open this up. This is going to be a very emotional unboxing for me, so if I choke up or anything, please do excuse me. This came in two large shipping boxes. This was in a box, and then that was in another box. So it kind of reminded me of Christmas when my aunt used to give me NES games, and she would put them in a box, put that box in a box, put that box in a box, put that box in a box. Got stubborn tape right here. I don't want to cut the box, because I am saving this box. I do not want to damage this box. Oh God, look at the inside of that. Oh, it's the floor puzzle. If you've seen Ghostbusters Afterlife, there is a scene where Phoebe has to do a floor puzzle to get a trap that was put in there by Egon. Oh, wow. Inside we have a small tiny trap. But what's in the trap? Does it open? Nope, they put tape on this too. They taped everything. Oh, we have tissue wrap. What is wrapped up in here? We have a burnt mini puff. Look at that. Oh. Now these have C-grip hands, so I can actually put these on my pack. I'm gonna set him over here. Oh, geez. There's another burnt puff. Now, from what I know, these are basically the same mini puffs that Hasbro released along with Afterlife, only they're a burnt variant. Oh, he's a grumpy puff. And there's more. Oh, it is the severed head of a mini puff. So I'm guessing that I can just... Yep. I can just rip the head off and replace it. Ooh, that's tight. Awesome. Okay, so we've got three figures and six heads, so I can change those about as I see fit. These are mischievous little guys. I love it. Got a box of phantasmical samples. Potentially sentient. Handle with care. Okay, in here we have the marshmallow attachments for the Proton Pack. I don't know if I'll use these, but they're fun to have. Does this lift up? It does. Oh, we got something over here. What is this? Ooh, the instructions. Kind of look like a blueprint. Oh, that's so cool. Got cubes. Oh, God. And, this is the Proton Pack. Oh my goodness gracious. I'm gonna set that aside for a moment. See what else is in the box. More cardboard. More taped cardboard. There's another box in here that's labeled Stan Spangler Nuclear Accelerator Storage Stand. Let's see what's in here. Okay, so we got stickers to replace the stickers on the pack if I want it to look like it's fresh from 84. More sets of stickers, just for whatever. Egon Spangler's journal. I was excited about this during the promotional teasing of what this pack is going to do. I'm going to have fun reading this. These are parts of the stand that I can actually use to prop up my proton pack. I'll assemble this off camera. And there's another box with more tape. This is the hose attachment for the proton pack. You'll see what I can do with this momentarily. I got a little orange nub that I can put on the end of my neutrona wand, so that way law enforcement doesn't believe I have a fully functioning unlicensed nuclear accelerator.
Excuse me, this is private property. Shut this off. Shut these all off.
This is the ion arm for my proton pack. I need to assemble that. It probably just snaps into place. And they taped this one to the inside of the box. This. Okay. The proton packs that you see in the movie are actually supported by an Alice military pack frame. This proton pack does not come with that, but it does come with all of the pieces needed if I were to assemble one myself. Okay, so it has been several days since I got the pack because I really wanted to have time to play around with it and find out all of the features that this has, how everything works. And I'm glad that I did, because if this happened on camera, I would have been absolutely dumbfounded and not know what to say.
Oh my gosh! That is the best thing I've ever seen.
So the way that this pack works is that while it is turned on, it'll idle for as long as about 3 minutes or so before the pack will automatically power down. However, if you have any connectivity with the wand, and you turn the wand off, it shuts the pack off then as well. So I encountered a very unfortunate issue with my neutrona wand, or at least not the wand itself, but the hose that connects it to the pack. The wand is powered by the pack now. There was a battery tray that was in the handle, but now it is in the hose. As I was playing around with this, if I even so much as moved the wand slightly, it would cut the power and thus shut the pack off. And I discovered that it was actually in this area right here where it connects to the pack, that if this area got jiggled even slightly, it would cut the power to the wand and thus shut the pack off. I did contact Hasbro and they are sending me a replacement, because yeah, they should, because this cost over $400. So that was very unfortunate. Thankfully though, a fellow Ghosthead on Twitter pointed out that if I attached a little electrical tape inside the coupler where this connects in, it creates a much sturdier connection and I can move the wand around freely and it works the way that it's supposed to. I've only had about one or two shutoffs because of moving the cord around while having the wand in hand. So I'm grateful for that I did take time to play around with this and find all the features and the Easter eggs. And I'm just going to go ahead and show you an overview of how the pack looks while it's running. I currently have it in afterlife mode. This pack has two modes, one that's more reminiscent of the classic 84 film and then afterlife. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn the pack on by flipping the red switch right behind the ion arm. Now what you're probably hearing over the sound effects of the pack is the loud vibrations. Even though the vibrations are loud, the vibration itself doesn't appear to be that strong. While having the pack on, I can really barely feel it. I kind of wish that the motors were a little stronger, but maybe by, fans can change that. with just custom mods. I've already seen a bunch of them that look really cool. Up here I have a volume dial. If I turn it this way, it turns the sound off. Turning it this way turns the sound back on. As you can see, I got the little mini puffs on here. This ribbon cable, if I detach that, it causes the pack to malfunction and shut down, but you can easily just clip it back into place. Turn this off. Now, to actually change it to 84 mode or to turn off the vibration, I can just unscrew the shock mount. Remove the bumper. Take off the faceplate to the cyclotron. And on the inside of here, you can actually see the CRT emitters that you can actually remove and play around with. I thought that was fun. Inside, you've got the cyclotron, which you can take out and remove, but I can only do this one-handed, so I unfortunately will not be taking it out. Now, these two switches in here, the left controls the vibration. I just turned that off. And the right switch is for afterlife or 84 mode, so I'm going to put it back into classic mode like that. Going to remount the faceplate. Put the bumper back on. And gonna turn on the pack again. Now this is with the vibration off and in 84 mode. And if I remove the ribbon cable in 84 mode, it actually plays the sound from when the containment unit was shut off by Walter Peck. I thought that was a pretty fun little nod. Also, while idling in 84 mode, you will either hear Slimer occasionally or Zool. I thought that was really cool. Now, the overview of the wand connectivity. Turning on the gun box. Extending the barrel. Now, the vibration in the wand cannot be turned off like it can be turned on for the pack. See, as I said, if I turn off the wand, that will then, after a moment, shut the pack off. Now, I am sure that there are still many Easter eggs to discover with this pack, and a lot of fan mods are going to really make this exciting and interesting in the years to come. I am glad to have been able to have the opportunity to get this. It's going to make my Ghostbusters cosplay, you know, up to the next level. I've been walking around the house with this thing. It weighs about 15 pounds. It's heavy, and you really notice the weight after a while, especially taking it off. It's just been great. I think it's mostly going to be spending a lot of its time sitting on this stand. I've yet to find a permanent home in my house for it. But it's just going to be a mainstay. I'm probably going to be going into our den, which is our entertainment room. But yeah, thank you for joining me for this. I'm glad to have been able to share it with you here on Tabo's channel. Thank you for joining us. Please subscribe if you haven't already. Leave a comment below. What's your favorite Ghostbusters movie or quote from the movies? Have an amazing day and an awesome tomorrow.